Our Martin Savidge has been tracking the story. And Martin, what is the latest?
Well, first of all, it's the arrest. It shows that even after the death of the alleged suspect here, that the investigation is continuing. Three people now apparently pulled in for aiding and abetting Adam Mays in some way, shape, or form. One of them apparently giving false and misleading statements to police. The other two apparently providing the weapon that in the end Adam Mays would use to take his own life. So where we're standing right here in this small town, Alpine, Mississippi, is where this ordeal came to an end. Actually, about maybe 100 yards down the road and just off down a very wooded trail. It's where the FBI was led by a tip last night. And when they went down that trail with a SWAT team of about 31 people, they came across one of the young girls laying on the ground. And a short distance away, they saw Adam Mays. They asked him to put his hands in the air. Instead, he reached for a gun, pulled it out, and shot himself in the head. And, of course, it only shows you that even by being at their moment of rescue, those girls still had to witness one more tragedy.
Martin, did the police have any sense at this point as to a motive?
You know, it's difficult to say, and of course that's still being investigated, but what people locally, when you talk to them about why this happened, they say that apparently Adam Mays felt that he was really close to these two young girls. Some have said that he thought he was their biological father. That's never been proven. But this family was getting ready to move to Arizona. Apparently he couldn't stand that kind of separation. Many believe that's why he acted when he did, also why he killed their mother and older sister, because he was fixated on the two young girls that were 12 and 8.
And do you know anything more, Martin, about their condition? Obviously, we're aware that they were released. Do we know to whom and what condition they're in? Or
right, they're released to close family. We understand, actually, their father was at the hospital when they were handed over. And as you point out, that physically they must be doing okay. We do understand that, of course, they suffered from being exposed. Dehydration was a problem, hunger, insect bites, and poison ivy. But physically, they seem to be okay because they were released in a matter of hours. Mentally, that's going to be another question, and we won't know that one for a long time. But for many folks here, they do believe it's a miracle. Their prayers were answered, although no one's saying that they wanted to see Adam Mays die. They wanted to see him in court.